Hello, my name is Jackie. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to manage territories. I'm signed in as a sales manager. I'll start by navigating to territories. This landing page lists my team's territories. Let's look at more information about the Division 1 territory. The Summary tab displays commonly used territory attributes. I can use Application Composer to add other attributes to this tab. From the Actions menu, I can delete this territory, including all of its children. The Delete Coverage action removes all of the selected dimensions as well as any coverage values for the dimensions. I can also add coverage if it has none. The Dimension tab displays the defined boundaries of the territory. This is where I can add or change the values that define the territory coverage. Dimensions include a set of attributes and their corresponding values. Objects that match these attributes will be assigned to this territory. I can change the values of these dimensions by clicking Edit. Here, I can select a dimension that I want to edit, and then select or deselect the values by clicking the shuttle buttons. Or I can click Edit to enter the values for the dimensions separated by commas. I can choose to add the values to those already selected or replace the selections. If I click Remove All, then all the dimension coverage values are deleted. The dimension definitions all become any. In addition to defining dimensions for territory coverage, I can also directly assign any number of customers to the territory. I can select customers to be excluded from the territory, even if the customers match the dimensions for the territory. Let's look at the Next tab. This tab displays the territory team members. I can add or remove team members and change the territory owner. I want to see the details about Peter Branch. I can create an email to a team member by clicking the team member's email address from either the Resources Details dialog or the Team Members tab. I can update team member attributes. For example, I can change the function for a team member to salesperson. I can also use Application Composer to add other team member attributes. If I go to the Summary tab, then I can click the name of the parent to open the Edit page for the parent territory. The Child Territories tab shows me the children of the territory. If I click the name of a child territory, then I can view and edit the details of that territory. To summarise, I click the Child Territories tab and then the name of the child to navigate down the territory hierarchy. I click the Summary tab and then the name of the parent to navigate up the territory hierarchy. The Create Territory button begins the process to create a territory that's a child of the one I'm viewing. Notice that Division 1 is the parent for this new territory. Peter Branch is the owner of the parent territory, and now he's the owner here. When I click Save or Save and Close, my changes immediately become the active definition for this territory. Saving in this UI is different from the use of territory proposals that require a separate activation step. Thank you.